Hello everyone. In our different sessions related to practicals, today we are going to discuss about identification tests of proteins. In this video lecture, we can detail about bio-grade test, ninhydrin test and the xanthoprotic test for the subject biochemistry. So for theory purpose, we should write the definitions of the protein and the classifications and their functions. So for definitions, proteins are the biomolecules which are made up of amino acids, and we can classify proteins as a structural, contractile, transport, storage, hormone, enzyme and production. So what is the function of a structural protein? They can provide structural components, and the examples are the collagen and the keratin. The second is the contractile protein, and what are its function? They can move muscles, for example myosin and actin. What are the transport protein? They can carry essential substances throughout the body, and example is hemoglobin and lipoproteins. Storage proteins can store nutrients, example casein and ferritin. Hormones are the proteins which can regulate body metabolism and the nervous system. For example is insulin and the growth hormone. Enzymes are also proteins, and they can catalyze biochemical reactions in the cell. Example is sucrase, trypsin, etc. And proteins are also protective in nature, and they can recognize and destroy the foreign substances, and example is immunoglobulins. So you can report the definition and classifications of proteins in the theory. Now coming to different tests used to detect proteins. There are different types of the tests which can use to detect the proteins, like gel-dal method, the enhanced Dumas method, the bio-grade test and the Lowry method. In gel-dal method, there is a titration based measured nitrogen, and then proteins are detected. In enhanced Dumas method, we can use detection by using a high temperature. Bio-grade test, when a high concentration of proteins are present, and we can use Lowry method when the low concentrations of proteins are present, and we are unable to detect through the bio-grade test. So these are the different tests used to detect proteins, but today we are going to discuss about the bio-grade test, the ninhydrin test and the xanthoprotic test, and these tests are used when a high concentration of the proteins are present. So coming to the first, that is the bio-grade test. So what is the process? We should take a test tube, and a same amount of NaOH are added to supplied solution. Means if we take 1 ml of protein, then we can take 1 ml of NaOH and we can mix it gently. Then add a few drops of 1% copper sulfate, and the mixture should be placed static without shaking. And then a purple color is a positive result. If a purple color is obtained, then the protein is present in the given test sample. So what is the color change? This figure represents the color change in the test tube. Your color in the test tube becomes purple in color. Now coming to the explanation portion. The reagent used in the bio-grade test is a solution of copper sulfate and the sodium hydroxide. The NaOH, that is the sodium hydroxide, is there to raise the pH of the solution and to raise the pH of the solution to the alkaline levels. And the crucial component is the copper Cu2+ ion from the copper sulfate. When the peptide bonds are present in this alkaline solution, the copper plus 2 ions will form a coordination complex with the 4 nitrogen atoms from the peptide bonds. The complex of the Cu2+ ions and the nitrogen atoms makes the color of copper sulfate solution changes from blue to violet. As we have already seen in the figure, the color it changes from blue to purple. And important point is that this color change is dependent on the number of peptide bonds in the solution. So the more protein, the more intense is the change in color. Now the second test, that is the ninhydrin test. The ninhydrin test is one of the most sensitive tests for amino acids and is given positive by all the free amino acids, proteins, peptones, as well as ammonia and other primary amines. It is used for the detection of all amino acids except proline and hydroxyproline because they don't have any free amino acids. So why we use ninhydrin for this test? Ninhydrin is a powerful oxidizing agent and causes oxidative decarboxylation of alpha amino acids producing carbon dioxide and ammonia. The reaction of ninhydrin with amino acids is as follows. The alpha amino acids plus ninhydrin gives aldehydes, carbon dioxide, ammonia and the hydrin dentin. This hydrin dentin plus ammonia and ninhydrin will form a blue complex. So what is the procedure? We should take clean test tubes, and if we take three different samples, then we can choose three different clean test tubes, and we can add 2 ml of the test substance. Then 5 drops of ninhydrin solution is added, and the test tube is heated over 2 to 5 minutes, and then the change in color is observed. This is the change in color which we can observe during performance of the practical. Now coming to the third test, that is the xanthoprotic test. Xanthoprotic test is used to differentiate between aromatic amino acids which give positive results. The aromatic amino acids will produce yellow color and the other amino acids do not. What is the principle for xanthoprotic test? The concentrated nitric acid reacts with the aromatic nucleus present in the amino acid side chain, and the nitration reaction will take place, which gives the solution a yellow color. The point to be noted is that the salts of these derivatives are orange in color. So here are 3 tyrosine, tryptophan and phenylalanine structures which are amino acids and containing aromatic rings. So they can produce different colors with this xanthoprotic test. The ring in tyrosine is aromatic in nature. Tryptophan is aromatic in nature, and phenylalanine is also aromatic in nature, but phenylalanine does not produce color with xanthoprotic test. Why? Because amino acids tyrosine and tryptophan contain activated benzene rings. These activated benzene rings are aromatic nucleus which are easily nitrated to yellow colored compound. The aromatic ring of phenylalanine does not react with nitric acid despite it contains a benzene ring, but it is not activated. Therefore, it will not react with the xanthoprotic reagent. So what will be the procedure? We should take 4 test tube and level 4 test tube for tyrosine, tryptophan, phenylalanine and phenol, and add 1 ml of each amino acid solutions or protein solutions and phenol solution to those test tubes each alone. Then add 1 ml of concentrated HNO3 and then record your result. Now cool thoroughly under the tap and add 5 drops of 10 molar NaOH to make the solution strongly alkaline. The alkaline is added to be sure about the nitration. So you should prepare your observation table for this test like this. You can mention your all amino acids, tyrosine, tryptophan, phenylalanine, glycine, or the protein samples which contain these types of amino acids. Then what will you observe by adding nitric acid, and what will be observed after adding NaOH solution? This is the color change which will be observed by tyrosine, tryptophan, phenylalanine and phenol. Now coming to the observation table and the inference, you can prepare your observation table by writing all the test names and as well as what are the reagents you can use for this test. And then you can prepare the observation which you can observe with biuret test, xanthoprotic test and then anhydrin test. And by all these observations, what inference you can get? If in the biuret test, if the appearance of bluish violet color confirms, then the inference is the presence of protein. In the xanthoprotic test, if the appearance of yellow color confirms the presence of proteins, so the inference is the presence of proteins. And in anhydrin test, the appearance of deep blue or purple color confirms the presence of proteins. So if deep blue or the purple colors comes, then it can inference the presence of proteins. That's all for this lecture. If you like this video, please do subscribe my channel. Just click on the subscribe button below this video and do subscribe to your friends. Thank you for watching.